The major problem in our firm, the problem is that there's a high percentage of unskilled labor in Italy. The root causes of our problem is that skilled labor is retiring and getting old. Another aspect is that the youth are not motivated to work, so there's a lack of purpose in our youth. Lastly, the education is less career focused. These three aspects are the root causes to our problem. Get cracking and find a solution.
An Ishikawa diagram to understand better the problem and all its main reasons and causes. So first of all, as we know, Italy has an aging population that is currently rising. This means that the skilled labor is mass retiring, leading to the creation of this generational gap. Also, we have the social structure problem. The social structure problem means that the young skilled labor is currently leaving the country to seek opportunities abroad. This because there is a general dissatisfaction on the system where there's uncertainty as the working contracts do not guarantee any type of security. And also, there's the low salary problem. As compared to the older generation, the young people have really low salaries. This added to also the poor working conditions with the poor communication, the lack of encouragement and recognition made the skilled labor going abroad. Also, we have the problem of the unskilled labor, where the young population has no motivation to seek a job or find higher education. This because of the dissatisfaction, of course, but also because the older population is willing to pay and sustain economically the younger population, as also there is a high level of youth unemployment, and the average Italians also leave their homes in their 30s. And now I pass the word to my colleague.
The problem-solving techniques we can use to decode the solution is the Osborne 7-step process. The first step is to pick out the problem. From my colleague's graph, we can see that there is a lack of training and a high level of youth employment, and this causes a shortage of skills in the workforce. The second step is to gather data, and the most common things we can find in the diagram is that there are many internal problems within the workforce in Italy, causing the environment to be negative. Now, we must analyze and get relevant material. Because there's a high level of youth unemployment, we must question the training given to the young workforce. Also because, from the diagram, people are dissatisfied with the work environment. We must find new ways to get young people happy and willing to work. Now we must come with a hypothesis, which is basically a prediction. The hypothesis will be that if we, as a firm, partner with training companies worldwide, then we can find young talent across the globe, and that is good because foreigners are always more motivated to work. Now we must put all the pieces together and verify it. The solution that we came up with is from our hypothesis is that we must partner up with training companies throughout the globe in order to find local and foreign talent. Then, by scouting new recruits, we can refer them to our clients, and this will improve the working environment and people will be more happy. This solution does relate to one philosopher, and that philosopher is Socrates. Socrates uses argumentation and persuasion to make his case, and in this case we did the same thing. We argued our problem, came up with logic, a 7-step process, and then from those steps we persuaded towards our solution.
Okay. Let's tackle this problem on its head, literally. Let's use the problem reversal technique to solve this problem and look at it from a different angle. Instead of starting from the beginning, where we are now, let's start from the finish line, from where we'll have skilled students, skilled uni-skilled students, foreign already skilled recruitment, and reskilled young labor within Italy. And how are we going to get backwards from there to where we are now? And so the solutions we came up with were we're going to provide skills and specialization courses in Italy throughout Italian high schools to give them the skills they need ready for the workplace. And for the university students, we'll be having partnerships with these universities, and that way we'll be creating connections and relationships with these students so that when they're ready to join the labor market, they'll be able to contact us and we'll send them on to our clients. And as you propose with your solutions for the foreign already skilled recruitments, we'll get them through the partnerships with foreign recruiting agencies, and through the reskilled young labor, we'll be outsourcing training skills courses in Italy. So now, if we apply Sir Bacon's scientific methodology to our solutions, these two solutions here, it brings up some questions because he believed that you actually gain knowledge through experience. instead rather than through deduction, as human thinking was seen to be as subjective by him instead of objective. So that means using this methodology, it brings questions such as how will we provide these courses after school, or universities will be ready to become partnership with us and students will be engaged with us and actually want to be a part of a relationship with us. And then if we look on the other hand, if we look at Voltaire, see, he actually believed in tolerance. And instead of Bacon's binary approach to knowledge, either deductive or inductive, Voltaire's philosophy allows two opinions to coexist and both be valid at the same time, despite any religion or beliefs. Forever in this disagreement, there will be agreement to meet a common space, which is called compromise. Voltaire's philosophy to our two solutions, we can accept the perspective of Bacon. However, we might not agree that our solutions are not viable because we use deductive thinking. However, we can take feedback and take some notes from his perspective to actually improve our solutions and make them more viable with objective facts and logic and decent deduction. Now I'm going to pass on to Philip. He's going to explain these processes with his flowchart.
Okay, so I've created a flowchart in order for you guys to see better how we get from the challenge of needing young skilled labor to actually having skilled labor to supply to our clients. So first of all, the first question we have is there young labor available in Italy or not? If we don't have young labor available in Italy, we come to the next question, can we get skilled labor outside of the country? If we can't, we have to try to find skilled labor elsewhere. But if we can, we can, as mentioned before by you, collaborate with global recruiting agencies and bring in young skilled labor from outside the country and then supply it to our clients. However, back to the first question, if we actually have young labor in Italy, we have to ask ourselves, is that young labor skilled or unskilled? If it's skilled, we can directly supply it to our clients, but if it's not skilled, we have to know whether they're attending high school. And if they're not attending high school, are they attending university? And if they're not attending university, we could provide them outsourced training in order to help them gain more skills, which ultimately leads to us supplying them to our clients who needs workers. If they are in high school, we have to ask them if they are willing and interested in further specialization. If they're not, we come to a dead end because we can't do anything with them. But if they are interested in further specializing, we can give them extra courses during their high school diploma in order for them to specialize to skilled labor, and then we can supply them to our clients. Or in universities, we can do collaborations with universities through events, which then they can see jobs which they could be potentially interested in.
Very good meeting, team. I definitely agree with the solutions. Now let's implement it and fix our problem.